Well, we are back.
Yes.
Better than ever. How are you guys today? Whoop. What is up?
What is up?
Oh, you went to
2022.
Yeah.
In the new year. It's going full force, fast, all the things.
Oh. I'm drinking out of
You're
a
drinking
Christmas
still
mug already. Wow. Or still, or whatever. That's crazy.
It must be a new year, new season, new day, old things.
It is not.
It is not.
No.
Welcome.
Thanks
about?
For joining us
yeah,
when
I'm
you
trying
tune
to
in.
Go to,
yes.
Yeah.
Sorry. So you know,
yes.
My personality style.
Yes.
Looks at certain things, and so this mug is tall and skinny.
Okay. Oh, it has a purpose.
It
guys.
Has a purpose.
It's intention.
It's super practical.
It's not just open the cupboard, grab a cup, pour some coffee, and drink. Now, I also like. I look, and I'm like, ooh, which cup do I want to hug today?
Yes. So,
but there's no practicality to it whatsoever.
So I do not like drinking out Christmas mugs any time of the year. Although this is tall and slim, and so it keeps the coffee more compact and warmer longer.
There's
so that is how I look at a mug. How's the rim?
Yep.
How's the feel in my hand? And is it going to keep my coffee warmer longer? Now, of course, Esther is like, what's the better experience? What's the feeling of
Absolutely.
The warmth in my hands and all that good stuff? So,
yes, that's how I would do it. Yes.
If you find this on Facebook or you find it on YouTube, we would be happy to come back and answer those questions or
yes.
comment on the comments.
Anytime.
So,
yeah.
Today we want to talk about, though, how valuing or understanding personality styles impacted our marriage. Changed,
yeah.
you know, the way we related to each other, as well as how we parented our kids. I know you hear us talk about personality styles a lot, but just in the ability to value one another and to value
yeah.
ourselves
yeah.
And to be our best selves and to help other people around us be their best.
Yeah.
It's super important to us
super.
Just to see people thriving in life.
Well, and we've so. Just seen such change once we went after that. To understand how we are wired and how the people in your life that are the most important, that you love the most, that you're with every single day. I mean, why wouldn't you want to understand, you know, how someone thinks or how they process certain things? Because it will change your life.
Right.
Like, that's what it did for us.
100%.
So you want to like give an example? I mean, I have many. So when you're like in our situation, we're super opposite also, you know?
Right.
So
to start off though, you know, I can't recommend highly enough to find, you know, go take some personality assessments, find somebody, come to us, whatever.
Find somebody.
Take some personality assessments
yeah.
as an
yeah.
individual, as a family, as a team, whatever it is, and
yeah.
not, and it's beneficial when someone goes over it with you. Like we like to go over it with people and just
yeah.
highlight, you know, different areas of strength, because you can overlook that thinking, you know, everybody thinks the way you think, everybody's the way you are. So highlighting those areas and then beginning to highlight how you can accommodate, work with other people, you know, champion,
yeah.
support other people. So the big thing was, what I find a lot, what we find a lot in marriages and relationships and whatever is, of course, there's always this kind of tension of you're different, which is cool, but
mm-hmm.
then this feeling of you're kind of hijacking our relationship, our family plans, what we're working toward, you know, comes into play. And that's where one of the big things I think for us realizing, understanding the different personality styles between Esther and myself and how we are complete opposite. And so what she values is different than what I value. The way Esther communicates is different than I communicate. And instead of being like, well, every time I have this idea, you hijack it, or every time I'm trying to do this, you come from the opposite way and just completely trash it. And why why are we not building the same thing in our family? Why are we not, you know, working the same way in our marriage? And just realizing those differences was huge. And then we could begin to accommodate one another, work with each other's strengths, allow that to be a part of, you know, I realizing I just don't think and operate that way. And so let me use Esther in that space, utilize who she is, and vice versa.
And also that for me, what was two big things was that there's a reason that you are the way you are. God created you in a way, a certain way. And so just because it's different doesn't mean it is wrong or that you need to be somebody else. So I used to think, because I didn't think like him, I didn't feel certain things or whatever, oh man, there's something wrong with me. Like I gotta change this who I am, you know, which I didn't realize that that's just who I am. When I did these personality tests and started reading, now, okay, I am an I personality, so I get excited about myself, you know, because I was born with confidence and those things. Like I heard people say, you know, they don't like themselves or they don't know what they like about themselves. And I could say things that I liked about myself. But I learned that's a personality trait, you know, of an I. And anyway, in our marriage, what was huge, because I kept putting it back to me, saying, okay. When we would have a conversation and I would say something or had an idea or a desire, and he would list all the things that was wrong with that, you know, or that's how I would see it. Oh, I would be like, you know, offended or whatever, and always think like it's something I need to change or there's something wrong with me. When I realized not just about myself, the way I am wired, but also the way his personality, like he needs some time to think about certain things. He is strategic in his thinking. He analyzes, he sees practical things that I don't think about at all. So he sees like details where I just look at the big picture. I understood all of a sudden, oh my word, that's just the way you think.
Right.
And that's how you were created to be, because it adds things to my life. It doesn't take things away from me. That's a big one. As that shifted, oh my word, I was like, I knew that there were times, oh, that has nothing to do with me. Like the way he responds, it's just he needs some time or he needs to figure it out, or it has nothing to do with me. Like there's nothing I did wrong. There's nothing I said wrong. He just processes different and he's wired different. And as I started seeing it as a strength to me and not something that like puts me in a box, or I mean, it's real. I mean, love is awesome, you know? A passion and all those things is awesome, but to really work in a relationship and work in life, you gotta work that relationship, and that takes work, you know. And so when I started learning that,
you gotta work that relationship, and that takes work.
But that's the truth, though. That's the truth. Yeah. I mean,
I'm joking. You gotta work that relationship. It takes effort. It's work.
But right. It's continual work, but it's not, it doesn't have to be a hard thing, you know, it's not always easy, but it doesn't have to be.
I was just joking that you use work over and over in the same sentence to define it.
I tend to do that. I tend to find a word and then I overuse it. Might be another thing. But it is really, you know, like love in the beginning, you know, in your marriage and stuff, it's. I wanted to change myself. Like I wanted to, I mean, maybe you weren't, but I know you probably, anyway, I just wanted to be more who I thought you wanted me to be, but that wasn't like you were, you know?
Yeah. Well,
I mean, does that make sense?
understanding the advancer or the lifestyle, their biggest fear is, or one of their biggest fears and concerns is social rejection. Mm-hmm. So they're built with a high external communication, expression type thing. Mm-hmm. But when they feel like they may be rejected or not accepted, that can be a challenge. And so, yeah, that's where just even recognizing that. So the feeling that you need to change in order to be accepted would be something that pops up.
Yeah. But I like also then having those harder conversations sometimes that he wasn't trying to change me. He, you know, that's a thing, like when certain things you don't talk about or you don't figure that out together, you know, I might be thinking a certain way where he has no idea that I'm even on that train, you know? And so for me, it really was like, there are just certain things about him that have nothing to do with me. It is how he was created, vice versa. But for me, being a feeling person, an emotional person, I'm sure most women can say amen, you know, that you take it personal. You take things personal. And while it might not have anything to do with you. That was huge for me because I have to take offense. It has nothing to do with me, you know?
So women may be a little more emotional, but you will still have the different personality styles. Oh, and some are just going to be, you know,
but
not pick up on
like
that.
High emotion.
Yeah, but high. But I'm saying that's not necessarily male or female.
No, right.
Because if you have, you know, a boy or a guy who's a high I advancer personality style, they're also going to be more of the feeling emotional, not necessarily the same maybe as a woman in that sense, but it's still going to be similar.
Yeah. Now, how do you, like, I mean, I might not be a set answer for that. And we have, you know, we've been married now for what, 16 years? So in marriage and in relationship, we know a thing or two. How do you stay true to who you are and not change who you are, but then, you know, also celebrate? Because that's really what it is. It's not just knowing who you are, knowing who he is, you know, but really celebrating who you are and the strengths that I don't have that you bring, and to pull from that and to see it as a strength, you know. Right. How do you, in a relationship, that's not always the easiest thing.
Yeah, so the biggest, the things we've worked on is, of course, identifying who we are individually and then, you know, who the other person is, as well as our kids, and then supporting that, but then going from that to actually, you know, working at pulling on. We don't have it perfect.
Oh, yeah.
No. We don't have it 100% down.
One of the things you said, sorry, a lot. You just say sorry a lot and you do it quick.
Now we begin to realize why, you know, certain communication or certain processing of a situation impacts the other person a certain way. And we can identify that and move through that a lot quicker. But you go from, you know, not just recognizing that style, but I work at intentionally communicating in a way that Esther appreciates. You're using certain types of words, highlighting certain things about her, and approaching her in situations through more of her style as much as I can. The same with the kids, approaching things in their style and celebrating in that and supporting them in that. And then as well as utilizing, see, we all have this desire to be used in our skill set and strength as well. So I feel like it's not good enough, and I think we both agree, it's not good enough just to say, well, you're this style personality and you can be that. And even, you know, I'll try to communicate more in that way, but if you're not able to be you and to operate in that style, you also don't feel fully engaged and alive. And that's where, you know, trying to position each other to utilize that strength that comes from that style is also a big part. Again, we still are navigating what all that looks like. But, you know, in light of your kids, you may give them chores. And one of our kids wants the whole list and they want to decide how they're going to put it, what order. You know, they're more the creator style, the D.
They want as much freedom.
They want freedom to drive this forward and
do it their way. So they just want to know the expectation, but don't tell them at all how they need to do it. Just not the easiest thing.
And then you take the flip side, more the executor style, the S, and our kids who are high there. When you give them that whole list and the freedom to navigate it and decide, they just crumble, blow up, you know, I can't handle it. And they need some steps put in place. They need to, you know, they want to know what's A, B, C, D. Don't just give me everything and help me figure out one thing at a time. And so just realizing and embracing that rather than, you know, even when we're driving somewhere, some people start asking questions and why did we make this turn and why are we going this way? And it's easy. You know, I used to do that. Just be like, okay, just I am driving. Let me handle it. I know what I'm doing. I know where I'm going. I know where the GPS is taking me. Let's leave it. I have other thoughts and plans on what we need to do on our way to this location. But just realizing that and figuring out, okay, I need to communicate maybe a little more information to some of the kids that are asking why we are turning this way, rather than just, you know, saying, trust me, let's go, and so on. And that's been huge. And then just as as you're raising your kids and teaching them different principles and things, just highlighting those styles and celebrating them.
And then also realize, you know, I mean, the other day with my overwhelm child that you cannot give the whole list to, I was in an organization mode and I felt like, you know, I wanted to get my house back into, you know, after all the holidays and whatever, you know how that goes. I go literally into a room because she asked me to help her with one thing. And I just went and, you know, we were looking for that one thing. So we went into the drawers of her desk. And I was like, and I'm coming to help her, you know, and I'm literally feeling like I'm helping her because I'm organizing and she'll be like clutter free, you know, and she'll be able to think again. And so I start pulling, oh, you don't need this anymore. Oh, you've had this for like so long. And then we went on to the next drawer, next to her bed. But she started getting overwhelmed because here she started getting into her thing and we weren't at all looking for the thing anymore. You know what I mean? And felt like she needed to organize and whatever. And so that wasn't at all what we were doing. And actually, I needed to say sorry because it made her upset in the end. Because we were just going to look for one thing, and here I like almost turned her whole room upside down. And recognizing that, oh man, shoot, you know, that's how she is wired, and that's not, she can't be her best if I do it that way. So if I want her to have a clutter-free room, because she will be functioning way better, it will be good for her in the end. However, the way that is done is step by step for her.
Yeah.
I would have to give her one area, one drawer, or one thing, and say, let's work on that today.
And the other thing was with that quick change in focus or the
also,
change in plan,
it's
difficult.
That is,
and
a big
so
one.
For you,
for me, it's like
you like to actually change mid sentence, mid project, because you just want change. It's like, oh, start. So you came in to look for one thing. Oh, let's do this. Oh, pull it apart and just let's get it. And for her, that quick change, that quick focus, that quick change of plans is a little more difficult to process.
Yeah.
And so this is the thing. You can say, well, okay, if you talk so much and you just focus only on that style, are you not trapping yourself or boxing yourself in? So yes and no, right? So you do want to highlight and operate in your strength, but you do want to have experiences outside that area to experience other pieces of life. So I'm a refiner, I'm a C, I'm detailed, analytical. Esther's an advancer, an I. She's that fun, spontaneous communicator. So two opposite sides of the spectrum. I can say, let me just stay in my analytical space all the time. Mm-hmm. But I think there's so much more to life than just staying there, right? Yeah. I don't want to try to operate and live 90% of my life outside of that, but I do want to take pieces and go outside of that space. And so with your kids as well,
yeah,
it's not just leaving them, you know, so our S-style child, our executor who got overwhelmed with the quick changes, it doesn't mean we don't ever bring in changes. I mean, life is full of changes.
Word,
as they grow up, life is going to change.
Yes.
But how can I support, how can I support that change so they can try something new? Because they would tend, that's why I forgot to put on do not disturb. they would tend to stay in the same place and not try new experiences, which is going to increase their life and increase their quality of life.
Yeah.
But it's, I give more information to them along the way. I say, hey, we're going to do this, we're going to do that. So for instance, when Esther went into her room and suddenly decided to change, she could have communicated, hey, I think we, while I'm here, let's work on some of this stuff and let's start here and we'll just clean this out. And then give her a little bit of time to process that rather than to just hit it full on, communicate as you go, and start like a whirlwind and she doesn't have time to just think through it. She doesn't have time to get some stability in that change. And so I think that's the big thing, you know? And
you know, in everything, you will have a more of a full life when you live your life for others. We don't live for ourselves. And that's in everything, in our relationships, friendships. But you live from yourself, so that does not mean that you totally ignore who it is you are. Right. And you know, you are a way better person when you understand yourself and when you love who you are and then from that place. So live from yourself, but not for yourself. So from that place, you give to others. And that's why we're here, you know. I'm in my marriage. I'm here to give absolutely my best to him all the time. Now that sounds perfect. Oh, great.
Doesn't always happen. Not at all.
No. But if I don't understand myself, if I don't like myself, if I don't love myself, well, for sure I'm going to give a crappy thing to him. You know what I'm saying? But we can't live for ourselves. We live for others. So I live for my children to give them the best of me. Sure. But that takes two things. That takes understanding them, but it takes understanding yourself too.
And that's a big value of the kingdom, right?
Yeah.
Serving other people and giving other people and loving others like you love yourself. So being confident enough to recognize who you are and to own that and be confident and stable in that. And when you're confident and stable in that, you can celebrate and honor the differences of the people around you and then not be afraid to shift yourself in order to accommodate them so they can be their best, because you now know that you are worth it, that you're valuable in your style and who you are.
Yeah.
And so you can better champion and support those around you. Mm-hmm. So we are here at the mark. Let's get it wrapped up so it's not too long. But again, you know, take some assessments, recognize, highlight who you are, you know, get some coaching around understanding your spouse, your husband, your wife, your boyfriend, girlfriend, or your kids, your friends, whatever it is. And then you begin to can have deeper and better relationships where you are all feeling honored, valuable, and able to be your best.
And we can help you with that.
Yeah. let us know. Hit us up.
Officially, you know, you are a what? Certified something?
Yes.
Personality.
Behavioral analyst.
Behavioral analyst.
DISC personality.
DISC personality. So for real, we can, you know, set you up and get you extensively and sit down with you and say, these are the things you need to focus on. Those are your strengths. Even in jobs where you would thrive and not, you know, where you can be your best self. Yeah. All those things, we offer those. If you want that, let us know. And we can set you up for that.
So here's the thing. You are awesome.
Yes.
And the people around you are awesome.
Yes.
So celebrate yourself today and then celebrate the people around you just by honoring and valuing them.
And don't change. Don't change. Because if you change, you're actually not who you're called to be. And you'll be miserable and the people around you will be miserable. So stay who you are.
You guys are awesome. Cheers.